Hi guys, Dan Tabar, late night here. I did want to make this video super quick for you because it is new stuff that just got unlocked by the core team. They've been working really hard on this soft removal, as we call it, but it's a lot more nuanced than that. It's something I want to just show you. It's a lot easier to just show and not tell. So this is where we can create anything, really. We could take any object. I just want to create like a gold bar here because they look real delicious. I will paint in a gold color, not color, but material, right? So this is where we can make this entire block or shape that we've created here into gold. Boom. So we've created this gold ingot, you could say. It's quite large. It doesn't look as shiny as it should be. I can paint this with more, let's say, roughness is maxed out, that's why. So let's actually make it super metal, super rough, and now it'll really look like an ingot. And we'll paint it up real quick here. This I could have just done before I created it, but here we have it, and now it's going to look a lot more shiny and delicious, right? Like a little too perfect maybe. The thing I can do is remove from it, like just like before. Nothing new about this necessarily. What is new here in the removal tool, however, is that there's a hardness parameter that remove hardness. So if I have it under a certain limit, then you will see that there's no effect on the gold I am clicking now. And if I go higher, it will start removing from here, and it'll be this effect from me removing, of course, like before, but it's kind of based on that material's hardness. So really cool thing here is if I put this in the ground, now we're talking about this deep representation of stuff, there is depth here. And if I now stamp this into the terrain has a lower resolution than the object. I can make the object lower resolution as well, but the rest of the terrain is lower than it needs to be, honestly. This is an older data set, but it's what we have available right now. But you can see conceptually what this will look like. If I reduce the hardness of my removal, you will see that it actually will dig away at the ground here, but the gold bar will be excavated, essentially. That material that was then placed in depth at these voxels is now being kind of revealed. And this is super relevant and compelling, of course, to our Cortex Command prototype, that where you're actually excavating gold, right? And you're gonna have digging tools that let you dig through things, and they will have, different kind of efficiency or power, you could say, that if I now crank up and imagine that I'm using a different digging tool that is more powerful, I will also dig through this gold, right? Just like here. And if you do this on a building, let's say like over here, like I've already done some of it, you will be removing both the metal and the concrete. Or again, if you have a more nuanced tool here, I'm now only removing the concrete and kind of stripping away the concrete from this metal that is embedded in the building, and all these windows and everything were voxelized with these metal details, let's say. And now, this is kind of how the bunkers in Cortex Command will have concrete for most of the wall, but then there's also reinforced kind of rebar in there. So this reinforced concrete that we will see have an effect on your digging efforts if there's a casing of metal around an important brain, let's say, that's hiding out in the bunker. You will need to penetrate that with some more powerful tools, possibly. So this is going to be this deep interactivity, this kind of super interesting stuff that we can build now in depth. This building kind of looks like it's all made out of some generic material here. It does have the metal stuff, but you can imagine a brick wall or a brick building that has mortar and the bricks. And at depth, you take this away, you can really see under the plaster, there's bricks, let's say, on brick wall. You would see all this when you shoot it or you dig into it. So that's it for now. I just wanted to show you, we do have a bunch of tests in here. We're experimenting. Like this brown stuff is actually very hard rock. And so if you you dig away this other stuff that's on top of it. You're kind of excavating these, what I think looks like kind of cat turds at this point. We will have so that the materials also have a specific appropriate texture to them, right? So when you're adding now, if I'm going to add more of these rock sausages, that's gold still, so let's make a rock. And now it also has that texture, the rocky texture, right? It looks like kind of polished rock. So if I make this more rough, it won't have that. It's more evident when you kind of look over here. So see, that rock is more shiny. It looks wet almost, or very polished rock, while the other stuff is more rough. But yeah, like when I now go and again remove, this rock is very hard. It has a very hard hardness, and it should not affect it. And it doesn't, actually. It does change the color and the texture of it. That's not intentional. I think that's a bug that we're gonna address. But you see when I'm removing the rest of this building, that rock, those rock sausages are remaining, and the gold as well, like before. So that's it, folks. I just want to show you that this is coming in now, finally. We have these materials actually making sense and having an impact on depth, at depth of this stuff. So you'll be able to dig for, you know, gold veins that you'll, like, you know, unearth gradually in the Cortex Command prototype, but also, you know, these bunker pieces that are submerged in the dirt will have much harder, you'll have a harder time getting through them than the dirt itself, right? So these are all fundamental things about virtual matter that can kind of unlock super interesting emergent gameplay, you know, that is stuff you probably haven't seen before in 3D. I haven't seen it, at least, and I've been looking for a while at everything out there that has to do with, you know, these kind of voxel representations and so on, and having it all work in a browser, as you can see, is quite remarkable. And you can have your friends in here doing all this with you within seconds of sending them a link. They can be on their phone, you can be in the browser, and this also works in VR. So you can imagine digging into this with your hands. That's coming very soon. So, all right, guys, I'm gonna wrap it up and go to bed. It's about 4 o'clock or 5 almost, so in the morning. So it's time. All right, see ya, bye.